In the previous video, we had seen how to create a basic pivot table and how to sort data. In this video, we will go ahead and see more about pivot table and its uses. This table shows the amount exported together with the product exported from each country at the same time. Now this is called as two-dimensional pivot table. Now create a pivot table using this table. If you have missed how to create a pivot table, please check my previous video on how to create a pivot table. Select on the fields product, category, amount, country in their respective areas. Finally, this table shows a two-dimensional pivot table. To simplify the visual representation of the data in the pivot table, we will use pivot chart. To do so, go to pivot table tools under analyze, select pivot chart. Insert any of these pivot charts. We will use a column chart. This is the basic pivot chart. Now, pivot charts can be filtered as required. We will check the export of fruits from each country. To do so, click on the category drop-down on the top left corner inside the pivot chart. We will select fruits. Here you can see the entire chart is filtered with the data related to fruits from each country. We need to display the amount of fruits, export it from this category, display the amount of fruits, change the chart, select change the chart, go to pivot table, change the chart, select change the chart, take a moment to check if you have understood two-dimensional pivot table and if not, you can always pause the video and go back. Next, we will simplify the pivot table by grouping the categories of fruits and vegetables. Create a pivot table. Select the cells having fruit names. Now right-click with the mouse on any cell and select group. The fruit items are grouped together. Similarly, all the vegetables can also be grouped. To do so, select all the vegetables and group them as you group the fruits category. To view only the group heading, click on the negative sign. Now these are the group categories of fruits and vegetables. Next, we will see to group by date. First, create a pivot table with the date field in the rows. Now in this pivot table, there are too many dates. To simplify the view of this pivot table, group the dates according to month. To do so, right-click inside the date column, select group. Select months. The dates are grouped by name of month. Take a moment to check if you have understood the grouping by categories and by dates. If no, you can always pause the video and go back. Next, we will see multi-level pivot table in rows field. First, create a pivot table with the category field in the rows area. Now drag the country field into the rows area. This pivot table shows countries exporting fruits and vegetables in separate groups. This is called as multi-level pivot table in rows fields. Next, we will see multi-level pivot table in values field. First, create a pivot table. In this pivot table, we want to show the amount and percentage of amount exported. First, to add amount field directly into the values area, right-click on the amount field and click add to values. The sum of amount field is added to the values area. Now right-click on any cell inside the newly added sum of amount column and go down to value field setting. The values can be summarized by these default fields, or you can create a new field. Just select show value as and enter the custom name. We will enter percentage as we have created percentage of the amount. In the drop down, select percent of grand total. Finally, the first field has the sum of amount and the second field has percentage of the amount. This is called multi-level pivot table in values field. Next, we will see multi-level pivot table in filters field. First, create a pivot table with the country and product field in the filter area. Filter the country to United Kingdom and product to broccoli. This shows the data of export of broccoli from United Kingdom. This is called multi-level pivot table in filters field. Take a moment to check if you have understood a multi-level pivot table in rows, values, and filters field. Next, we will see frequency of distribution of values in pivot table. Create a pivot table with amount in row and sum of amount in values area. Now, if you have missed how to create a pivot table, you can check my previous video to create a pivot table. Now, right-click on any cell in sum of amount column and select values field setting. You can see the count of values accordingly. Right-click on any cell in the first column and select group. Enter the start value as start at 1. Enter the end value as ending at 10,000. Enter value for by as 1,000. This means that there will be groups of 1,000 each till 10,000. Now this shows the frequency of distribution of values in pivot table. To compare these numbers easily, create a pivot chart. Now take a moment to check if you have understood the frequency distribution in pivot table. If no, you can always pause this video and go back. Next, we will create a slicer in a pivot table. A slicer can be inserted in an Excel to quickly and easily filter the pivot tables. To do so, first create a pivot table. In the pivot table tools, under analyze, select insert slicer. Select on product slicer. This gives you a list of all products from the pivot table. Select only apple. You can see that the pivot table is updated, displaying all countries exporting apple. Change the product. You can see that the pivot table gets updated. Take a moment to check if you have understood the slicer in pivot table. Next, we will calculate tax for each country in the pivot table. To do so, first create a pivot table. In pivot table tools, under analyze, select field items and settings. In the insert calculated field dialog box, write the name as tax. Write the formula as equals to if open brackets amount is greater than 100,000, 3% multiplied amount, 0 close bracket. This means that if the amount is greater than 100,000, then multiply the amount by 3%. This is the result. The sum of tax is 0. This is because the formula states that if the amount is greater than 100,000, then multiply the amount by 3%. But you can see that no amount is greater than 100,000. To change the formula, Go to the Insert Pivot Table tool under Analyze, under Field, Item and Settings. Select on the calculated fields. Inside the Insert Calculated field, select Tax field from the drop-down. Update the formula from 100,000 to 10,000. Now this is the updated calculated field. We can calculate taxes according to the group of countries. To do so, select any cell inside the country column in the Pivot Table tools under Analyze, under Field Items and Sets, select Calculated Items. In Insert Calculated Items in Country dialog box, write the name as Northern America. In the formula, note down equals to 3% multiply open bracket Canada plus inside inverted commas United States and close the bracket. Group is formed which shows the tax calculated only from Canada and United States. Take a moment to check if you have understood to calculate values in Pivot table. Create a two-dimensional pivot table. Now we want to see the amount of beans exported from Germany. To do so, enter the cell number which shows beans exported from Germany. Write equals to D8. Now the cell value is displayed. We will filter the categories to fruits. You can see the export value is changed to 0. This is because the value in the cell D8 is blank. Now filter the category to vegetable. You can see the export value remains as 0. This is because the value in cell D8 is still blank. Now filter the category back to all. The export value is displayed because the value in cell D8 is displayed. Now to solve this problem, we will use getPivotData. We will use the following formula in the cell equals to getPivotData open brackets in inside inverted comma amount comma $A$3 comma inside inverted commas product comma in inverted commas bills comma in inverted commas country comma in inverted commas Germany and close bracket. This formula means that from the entire pivot table starting from cell A3, get the amount where the product is beans and the country is Germany. This is the amount of beans exported from Germany. Now we will filter the categories back to vegetables. The export value remains unchanged even if the value in cell D8 is blank. The entire pivot table starting from cell A3 is checked for product beans and country Germany, and the amount is displayed in the cell below. Now filter the categories back to fruit. You can see the export value shows error. This is because beans is not a fruit and is not displayed in the pivot table. In a similar way, if we want to get data from the cell value, we will write the formula equals to get pivot data open bracket in inverted commas amount comma $A$3 comma in inverted commas product comma B14 comma inverted commas country comma B15 close the bracket. This means that the entire pivot table starting from cell A3 is checked and values similar to cell B14 which is Apple and cell B15 which is United States is checked and the amount is displayed in cell B16. This is the displayed value. Now we will filter the category back to fruits. You can see that the export value remains unchanged. We will filter the category back to vegetables. The export value is showing an error. This is because the cell value is apple could not be found in the pivot table. And obviously, apple is not a vegetable. To find the total export from USA, we will write the formula equals to get pivot data open bracket, in inverted commas, amount, comma, dollar A, dollar 3, comma, in inverted commas, country, comma, in inverted commas, United States. This means that the entire pivot table starting from cell A3 is checked, where the country is United States. The final total is displayed. Filter the category to fruit. The export value changes accordingly. Take a moment to check if you have understood all about get pivot data. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Click on the bell icon to get reminder of my new videos. See you all next time.